Hello, I'm Dr. Lawrence Lloyd of Lloyd Podiatry. Here we are at my Anderson office in Anderson, Indiana, with a patient that has a condition we call ram's horn nail, but it's also infected. It's called a ram's horn, like the ram that has a horn that tilts over like this, so you can see the shape of that nail. If you want to zoom in here, you can see also a little bit and come closer, see how this nail is kind of not really connected very well, and there's an odor coming out from underneath it from an infection that's underneath there. She's just had a situation where she wasn't able to cut it for many, many years. So we're going to remove the nail, kill the nail root so it doesn't keep coming back. You can see how this nail rubs against this other toe right here and would have caused an ulcer and infection here for her. So here you can see this nail again. Now, this is going to be, most people would come and kind of cut on the sides or cut back here. I find that one of the easiest ways to do it is just use the toe as a little bit of a lever, and you can say abracadabra, and the nail is gone. So you can see how much of that nail, how diseased it is underneath there. This is where the smell is coming into the room now from the infection. Look at this, terrible. So, but this is why she's here, to get rid of this. Now, you'll notice how clean that is, instead of trying to dissect it, how clean that is. You notice we don't have bleeding, which disrupts the medication that we put on there, it dilutes it. Now we'll kind of clean out these margins a little bit here. This nail bed, and we're going to put a little medication on here today to, this is a little povidone, so we're actually going to use this as a little antiseptic to kill the germs that are hiding underneath the original preparation, the surgical prep. We find this reduces the infection process. This is something that a lot of surgeons don't do. I found that this hastens the healing so that we have diminished seepage and drainage postoperatively. So now that we have this nail bed prepared, we're drying this a little bit. Now what we'll do is we'll actually take a little of a medication, type of an acid, and we're going to cauterize this root of the nail and see if we can make it so this nail never comes back. One of the key things about the surgery, if you're a surgeon out there, is that I have a dry field. For those of you who aren't surgeons, that means that this is there's not blood. And the reason is that if there's blood in this area, what will happen is that the medication becomes diluted and it's less effective, and there's more likely to have a return of the nail. So you can see that chemical change, this whiteness, that's a chemical change that's going on as the medication denatures the proteins and the tissues in that part of the nail bed. She's going to have a wonderful result. We've placed her on preoperative oral antibiotics already so that the tissues are perfused with the germ-killing properties already. And then postoperatively, we'll continue that for about a week, as well as have her soak it in a germicidal medication postoperatively, as well as an antibiotic ointment that they'll apply. So we'll go ahead and take this off. She'll remove this dressing in just 2 hours because we're going to put some compression on here. You notice it's not bleeding much yet. We have her foot elevated a little bit so she doesn't have much pressure underneath there. We're going to put this dressing on, a little thicker than I would like, but it'll be okay. She'll just have this on for 2 hours. and she should do just fantastic. And she'll care for it daily. She can do whatever she wants, including going swimming. And she should do very well. I want to thank you for watching.